In the last few years, we've seen a staggering increase in video consumption, while worldwide internet bandwidth hasn't kept the same pace. My name is Ranganathan, and I'm here to talk to you about how the WebM project is solving this problem today. Video accounts for over 50% of the peak internet bandwidth and over two-thirds in certain parts of the world, and it's growing fast. The WebM project is a collection of open source media codecs and technologies aimed to address this problem. How well does this work? VP9 can halve the bitrate compared to H.264 for the same quality settings. This has massive implications for the web, especially YouTube, who now serve billions of VP9 playbacks to their users. This is because YouTube is seeing both a decrease in average bitrates and an improvement in quality over 264. So what does this mean to YouTube customers? VP9 provides a better streaming experience, reducing rebuffers by 25% in developed markets and a whopping 100% in emerging markets. This means videos to more places. In fact, because of VP9, we are able to serve an additional 25% of videos in HD worldwide, and they load 15% faster, which you will notice is giving YouTube the ability to add a checkbox to stream 4K videos. And the truth is, working at YouTube scale has allowed us to dramatically improve VP9 in this past year. For starters, we've improved the encoding speed by 40x. To meet the demands of YouTube, we've added three new controls to the encoding process. The first is variable bitrate, controlled by the target bitrate parameter, allows you to hit specific bitrate values. Constant quality, controlled with the CQ level parameter, allows you to hit specific quality values for your encode, while the constrained quality is a hybrid mode that allows you to balance between the two, allowing you to conserve bitrate after hitting a quality goal. To provide even more control of your encodes, especially trade-off between computational complexity and compression efficiency, you can use the CPU speed parameter to navigate. We're also providing an additional trade-off point between speed and encodes with a functional one-pass encode option. Quality-wise, this is usually within a few percentage points of a two-pass encode with similar settings. Next up, VP9 has three adaptive quantization experiments to adjust bit expenditure within a frame to give better psycho-visual quality. If you look in more detail at the large 64x64 blocks in the top center, at a fixed quantization, we're spending only a few bits for the whole region. In contrast, for some of the regions down on the tracks, you're spending several thousand bits. The AQ modes try and correct the balance a little by reducing expenditure in these expensive areas, while we're taking a few bits won't visually hurt much, and increasing the expenditure in the easy sections like the sky and hillside, and can overall improve the visual quality. Now, these are set using the AQ mode command line parameter, and for more information on how to control adaptive quantization, check out webmproject.org. Now, video on demand is a significant proportion of the video on the internet, but real-time communication and screen sharing are very important to us as well. I'm happy to announce that VP9 now has a functioning real-time encode option for video conferencing and screen sharing. At the start of the year, measured against speed -5 of VP8 for HD content, VP9 encode was 25 times too slow. With the addition of a non-RD path and many other optimizations, this is now down to about 2x, but delivering about 40% compression gains, or about 1.4x, delivering about 20% compression gains. Now, real-time enables screen sharing applications to use VP9. However, screen sharing requires high-fidelity text and color space rendering. Towards this, we're also announcing experimental support for 444 and 422 color profiles to VP9. Now, we heard you loud and clear that you needed simpler tools to encode videos into WebM. So we announced a few open source tools to make these process better. Check out Demystifying WebM Encodes and Decodes for tips, tricks, and tools to encode and playback WebM files. The team has been hard at work making decode better, especially on mobile, with a strong focus on multi-core performance and improvements to battery life. We've made VP9 decode over 7 times faster since June 2013. In fact, we can do consistent, continuous 1080p playback on your Nexus 5. And over 10 companies have licensed the VP9 RTL for adding fixed function hardware decode, including MEDIATEK and NVIDIA. Now this means that you have low power, 2160p, 60 frames per second decode in devices in 2015. Finally, we began work on a new high bit depth profile for VP9, which will support both 10-bit and 12-bit video. You can follow its progress on webmproject.org, and we're doing this work in two phases. In the first phase, all internal buffers will be upgraded to 16 bits, along with all filtering. but your input and output would still be 8 bits. With the higher internal precision, we expect some huge coding gains. In the second phase, we will increase the precision of the transform coefficients to add extra 2 or 4 bits of precision and make other changes as appropriate for the bitstream syntax. We anticipate that work on the HPD profile will be concluded by the fall of 2014. Now, we worked very hard to make VP9 an open project and to help you provide a great video experience through the web across many of these devices. Now, it's your turn to start telling great video stories on the internet. For more information on creating and playing back WebM videos, check out Demystifying WebM Encodes and Decodes, and as always, we are here to help.